I'm sorry, sir. Are you lost? We don't have any services scheduled here for today.
I'm here for you, Mr. Polidori.
No good conversation ever starts like that.
I'm Morris Winslow, the litigator for the hunting party.
You're the litigator? What happened to Alexander?
Mr. Yagdund passed away at 3:42 a.m. last evening from undetermined causes.
He died? I mean, did his head finally actually explode from always hating everything forever?
Ha. No, we don't know why. We just know that the heart monitor we installed into all front office personnel triggered code blue, ending his employment term immediately.
You guys actually do that? What, did someone see the movie Spawn and think that was a cool idea?
The movie studio responsible for Spawn actually licensed the concept from us, for a fee and an NDA, of course, with creative license highly encouraged to keep the nature of the real technology a secret.
That entire sentence is so ridiculous that actually has to have happened.
The details are classified, but suffice it to say that the events did occur in that general sequence.
If it helps, Mr. Polidori, that sentence isn't nearly as ridiculous as Morris Winslow's so-called legal credentials.
Okay, so not dead Alexander, who was dead, now isn't. Would you care to, you know?
I'm employed by the First Hunter now. After he corrected my post-mortem status, I couldn't say no to his offer.
Literally? Huh? He actually couldn't say no. He was converted. The First Hunter converts regular people now?
Alex is many things. Regular is not one of them. Also not one of them, a quality human being.
The blood of my ancestors turns out to make even a living human just the tiniest bit vampire. The only regret I have in dying and then being brought back to life via conversion is that this fool has taken my place.
Well, you know what they say. When one door closes, that same door opens anew. Because it's my office now.
I don't see Simon fighting an ambulance or a celebrity, so why are you here?
Mr. Polidori has been having some issues with the hunting party, so I wanted to help smooth them out and let him know how valued he is to us.
Well, that's a coincidence, because I'm here to tell him exactly why he's valued, quotation marks.
I'm right here, so you can actually just tell me.
Simon, what do you know about your early ancestry?
I have some.
What do you know about the first popular written story about vampires as we know?
Bram Stoker's Dracula?
It was before that. It was The Vampire with a Y, and it was written by Dr. John Polidori.
So, I have an ancestor who wrote a story. Go me!
Dr. John Polidori wrote the short story as a way to cover what he was actually doing. He met, befriended, and traveled with a woman named Ruth. He wasn't a hunter, but through his training as a physician, he was able to deduce her vampirism completely on his own.
Alex, do I really have to remind you that you signed extensive documents expressly forbidding you from discussing
Those
classified...
agreements apply only in that lifetime. I died, then came back to life, so this would be my second lifetime. Privilege no longer applies.
Sustained. Overruled. No? Nothing? Okay.
The woman named Ruth, who we call Lord Ruthven in the short story, turned out to be the Dracula. And he very nearly killed her. Fully.
I know this may be hard to believe, but as it turns out, the Dracula is, in fact, a woman. These are the kind of inside informational tidbits that you can expect to get if you remain with us.
You know, actually, I already knew that. I figured that out 2 days ago.
What? How? Who told you?
Well, she showed me. No way, that doesn't sound right. Okay, I was on my knees, and she was standing over here. Okay, this is getting worse and not better.
You didn't report to us the sighting of the Dracula.
You didn't get that report? Maybe I didn't feel like writing a report. So anyway, I was pretty surprised to hear that whole Dr. John almost kills the Dracula thing. How do you know that? Was that in the story?
No. He wrote the short story as a coded message to the hunting party on his findings. After seeing it went unheeded...
Imagine my surprise.
He traveled to Europe, trying to find a way to destroy her permanently. After he saved an old Romani man being hunted by vampires, the doctor had a holy weapon forged for him. A weapon built to kill the Dracula.
That's my dagger. What'd you do to it?
Sydney had something done to it that has never been done before. It was cleaned.
This thing can kill the Dracula? Why didn't we put this in the hands of some badass elite hunter?
Holy weapons are kind of alive in a sense. They develop an attachment to the blood of the wielder. A Polidori's hand must be holding the handle if it is ever to be driven into the Dracula. It won't kill her for anyone else.
Is this true?
It's part of a legend, Simon. I can neither confirm nor deny any of it.
So it's true. All right. So, you said you got this from Sid. Did you finally kill her?
No. We worked together. She was also converted by the First Hunter.
You work together?
It only works because we're completely under the thrall of the First Hunter, who commanded me to tell you your place in all this.
Why does he want me to know?
Because he wants her dead, as do I, unlike the hunting party.
Excuse me?
Oops.
You are a real piece of work, you know that? And of course, by work, I mean shit.
Why do you think I went and found the cell the First Hunter was stumbling around in 30 feet underground for 400 years? Because the front office only wants the status quo, perhaps?
Because you're a psychotic, revenge-obsessed descendant of a demonic bloodline, perhaps?
Says the ambulance-chasing, celebrity-worshipping movie studio lawyer who crawled all the way out to our office straight out of that barren Hollywood wasteland.
I warned the front office about choosing you over me the first time. You being a son of Alucard, it was just a matter of time before your compulsions took the place of your actual responsibilities. This guy's desk and itinerary are littered with a backlog of cases, depositions, white papers. You know, your goddamn job.
Which I'm sure you'll deftly take on and completely fail in my absence. Morse Winslow's personal motto when it comes to fault? Anyone. Me.
You were personally chosen for your job by your predecessor, Neil Jones, and this is how you respect his legacy?
So now you suddenly revere him? You always hated the old man.
I found the legend of Neil slightly lacking after he decided to end a brilliant legal career by putting your crazy ass in the litigator seat.
Okay, everyone just shut up. Just shut up. Mr. Winslow, do you know why I wanted to quit the hunting party?
We can discuss this once this nutbag takes his leave.
You just spent 5 minutes yelling with this nutbag about ridiculous legal nonsense that had nothing to do with killing the Dracula. What in the world are we doing if we are not working on killing the one vampire that kills all the other vampires?
Doing something like that takes the proper groundwork, Simon. You have no idea what's involved in doing something like that.
This end goes into the Dracula. His boss's hammer goes upside the Dracula. An elite hunter's holy weapon goes into the chest of the Dracula. We kill the Dracula.
Don't you dare talk to me like that, you pathetic drifter-looking motherfucker.
Finish that word. Go ahead and finish it. This guy got me to kill a man once just by lying to me about him, and I'm feeling pretty gullible today. Want to see if I would fall for it again? The hunting party is all about playing games with monsters. To what end, I don't know, but I'm removing myself from the pawn slot. I'm out.
Okay. So where are you gonna go then? You gonna join the Guild? Grim Center? RTC? Aiden 5? No, you're not. They're not gonna take you after the Daughter of Dracula incident.
I'm going solo. I'm gonna kill every vampire, zombie, werewolf that I come across. I'm gonna find a way to get to the Dracula, and I'm gonna kill her myself or I'm gonna die trying. There are exactly two things that the hunting party can do about this. Nothing and like it.
Where was badass Simon Polidori when I was alive? The first time.
Tell me, we couldn't give this to an elite hunter. Why aren't we elite hunters ourselves?
Considering what he was capable of, they needed to make sure the rest of you stayed as pathetic as possible, to keep the risk as low as possible.
You were a part of that.
I was, but even your shitty assignment and this dump couldn't change the legacy you came from. The reason I had to babysit you personally...
Don't you dare say it, you bastard!
It's because when you failed to kill the daughter of Dracula, the front office was afraid you had figured out something.
What? Figured out what?
That, I'm afraid I actually don't know. There are secrets the front office keeps to themselves and themselves only. If this all goes as my employer has planned, this should be over soon, so it won't matter. I've got to go. Good luck, Simon. For the first time ever, I'm actually rooting for you.
I am done with the hunting party. Take me off your mailing list.
I'm sorry to hear that. I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors.
You're gonna need it.